1974, things were finding their shape. Enrollment was up. School colors had been chosen. The board was a good cross-section of the community, a little bit of everything. Teacher turnover was still about 50% every year, but the programs were doing well. While the design of our campus was winning awards overseas, the reality on the ground was beginning to work its magic.
It was a pretty school. You know, the ambience was lovely.
I walk to the parking lot, I could just feel it. The charisma, you know, the feeling there was beautiful. And people really liked to go to work there. And after you started working there, you didn't want to leave. It was so nice, yeah.
GIST was a place that you immediately felt, wow, this is a fun place to be. You know, kind of talking to people at the fountain and next to the trees and in the huts that were outside, open air.
And you can see how the campus very much had that community college feeling to it, outdoor and round. It was round shapes. Everything was modules. And then the spaces created by the buildings, like this outdoor space here, where there was a big tree and fountain, where we had the senior slave sale and all the major student outdoor assemblies, was also modular in shape. And the classrooms were pie shapes,
very different than any other school that I had ever attended, which was more of a block building.
The teacher was on the inside at the small end of the classroom, and the pupils were all looking in. So this gave them focus. But if you want to learn well, you don't want to stay focused for long, long periods of time. You want to break the focus and come into a state of diffuse consciousness. So that when you come out and you walk on that pathway and immediately you're faced with a beautiful garden, and your feeling goes like that. So all the people that are being educated in that particular environment are automatically having a training which is going on unconsciously, that they're focusing, diffuse. You see?
What I really loved about it, because it worked, you know, we had the honor pastime. And we said, well, why do they have to go to a study hall? Why can't they sit out there in the benches and in the huts? And, you know, as long as they're in class on time, what difference does it make whether they go to the study hall or the library or... And so there was a freedom and a trust.
There's very little that's ever been done in the school, I think, that wasn't controversial at the time. And then after the controversy dies down and time goes on, people forget there was even a controversy. The swimming pool was a big deal for a long time. And it's dedicated down there to the American ambassador. Well, his board representative was the chief opponent to the building of the pool.
Yongwan Yoon arrived at GIST early on, with little English. An all-around nice guy and member of the Joint Sound, he graduated at the top of his class in 1974. When school returned after the summer, news broke that he had drowned on a holiday in Bali. It was the first time we experienced a loss like this, and it was quickly decided to name our valedictorian award for him, which is still the case today. For Wydell, it confirmed the need of something which had been on his list from the beginning. But there was a lot of opposition. After all, the Americans already had a pool at the American Club. The debate was invigorating. People at Patamora felt disadvantaged, but over at Chilandak, it challenged people to expand their mind about what their school could be or should be. It boiled down to one simple question: is this a school or a country club? Wydell kept pushing, and in the end, it was Ambassador Newsom who found the elegant way out. A pool, you see, would be invaluable in the case of a large fire.